I'll make one more standard croissant. Now let's make a couple of chocolate ones. This has already started to bounce back a little bit. The dough has kind of sprung back, so I want to flatten them out some more. Okay, that's so not uniform, but it'll work fine. And I'll take the couple of pieces of baton that we made yesterday. Just roll that up. And that's ready to rise. Do one more. See, the nice thing about me doing this is that it should be an inspiration for you if you're just beginning and wondering if this is very difficult. How hard can it be if I can do it, right? And these will work out, I can almost promise you. So if I can do it, then guess what? Okay. Let's try these savory ones. I think these should be square shape, not rectangular. So I might have to change this later if this doesn't work. So last night I made up three different fillings. One is a roasted beets with herbed goat cheese. Unbelievably tasty. These are, besides the sweet ones, these are way more suitable for an afternoon or evening meal. And by the time it takes you to finish the recipe, it will be afternoon or evening. So let's see, how does this work? Okay, I guess you could just make them like a regular croissant. I mean, a regular chocolate one. That's not what I had in mind, but I think this will work. What I had in mind for shaping them was a square. This one is apple sage gouda, smoked gouda. And, again, really flavorful, and you won't get a crazy sugar spike from eating them. Ah, here we go. That's what I was thinking. Yeah, let's try that. And this one is kale and minced garlic sauteed together and also mixed with some herbed goat cheese. I've already got one pan filled up. Now we'll start a second one. All right, so these are ready to proof. Now they're gonna proof for about, 2 hours at least. Probably more like somewhere between 2 and 2.5. And I'm gonna cover them with plastic wrap. while they're proofing. And we'll know they're done proofing when they get, when they rise and are kind of poofy. If you're wondering how to enjoy fresh baked croissants in the morning without having to wake up at 2 a.m. to start the recipe, you're going to have to freeze them. Most people will freeze them right after they're done shaping them, and then you can take them out in the evening to let them proof overnight, and they're ready to bake in the morning. What I prefer to do is let them finish proofing and then freeze them. Then you can take them out of the freezer anytime you want, put them into a preheated oven, and they're ready to enjoy in about 30 minutes. So we're going to do that this time, and we'll see how it works out. It's been about 2 hours and 20 minutes, and I think they're about ready to go in the oven. They've risen nicely, and they're a little bit poofy to the touch. I'm going to take a plain one and a chocolate one and one of the savory ones and put them in the freezer. And tomorrow we'll take them out of the freezer and bake them and see how they turn out. Before we put them in the oven, I'm going to hit them with a little egg wash. That'll help give them a little bit more of a golden brown color. And into a 400 degree oven till they're done, about 15 to 20 minutes, probably closer to 20 minutes. There's my favorite sound. I think these are done. It wasn't quite 20 minutes. I think they look pretty good. Now the hardest part of all, and that's waiting for them to cool. They're ready to eat, and I found a willing guinea pig to try one out.
He twisted my arm.
Go for it, Denise. It's kind of like Christmas. You don't really know what's inside until you open it.
I'm going to open this one.
That is the apple, gouda, and what else was in there? Sage.
You don't want this.
That's what I thought. Okay. Oh, yeah. Oh, I know. This one's the beet. I can tell this is the beet one because it's red on the outside.
Oh, how beautiful.
These are so good. You can't even imagine. So please take the effort to make these. Actually, it's more take the time. It's kind of a time intensive project, but it's so worth the effort. And tomorrow we'll bake those frozen ones and see how they compare. It's great when you can get up in the morning and have some awesome croissants ready to enjoy in about a half an hour. These are the ones we baked yesterday and froze overnight. They're quite frozen. So we're gonna pop those in the oven. These are the frozen croissants we just got done baking. They look pretty good to me.